Poet Laureate, Tim Seals.
It's a poem called Ode to Your Father. I'm at the age now where my parents are very old and not well. And so you spend a lot of time kind of thinking about who they were or what your sense of them was. So this is a poem that came out of that. I do mention in this poem Yusuf Lateef. Some of you know who that is. He was a great jazz flautist. Beyond that, I think everything will be pretty clear to you. Ode to your father. So Sunday nights, he put on Yusuf Lateef. And that flute stole secrets, usually locked in the moon's cool house. And you watched his head nod yes to all he couldn't say. Then tiptoed back to TV, hoping he'd forget it was past your time for bed. When he yelled at you, you probably heard his father yelling at him. But you couldn't recognize the flat, don't talk back, settled beneath his voice like a big bass at the bottom of a lake. Growing up, he said, yes, sir, to that brassy baritone, and wasn't his father's father's voice a part of him too? That part that seemed tied up in some long ago trouble, even when he sat in the shade, baiting a hook. Hard to picture it now, him in his straw hat and high water dungarees. Oklahoma boy moping home with a loaf of bread, his buddies teasing and tempting him back to the park. How did he face his first bully, the one that cracked his tooth and cut his arm? Ever wonder where he got that hot grease in the face glare? The look that made you so afraid. His father made him fight that tough kid twice. And at times, didn't the whole country try to break his skin, waiting for him on every corner like a bully? What did he make of all those stores that wouldn't let him in? He worked the slaughterhouse, stiff with dry blood. His overalls could stand by themselves. In spite of this, you found him years later, your pop mopping the kitchen, whistling My Satin Doll, a tune you hadn't heard, so half listened as if he was some odd station on the radio. And when he'd start the old, things were different back then. It sounded like once upon a time, you shrugged and secretly rolled your eyes. But half of you is still made of him, his long arms, his love of hats, your solitary heart, half jazz, half ready to fight. Your father didn't kiss you like your mother did. But every October, he drove you to the Arboretum to see the blood orange leaves. Even when he had a lot on his mind, that mind you'll never see inside, though you know it's packed with good songs, some hard feelings, and all the stuff he will not say.